Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we will create this fire effect using Share Graph. I am using Unity version 2022.2, but it will work on any Unity LTS version. I have created a project in URP. I have a scene with a ground plane, basically just a plane, a post-processing volume, directional light without shadows, and a main camera. I also have a nice little fire pit model to showcase our effect. Let's drag that in. Let's reset it. Let's add a quad as a child of our model. Let's call it fire and adjust its position a bit, just like that. Now I'm in post-processing volume. The main effect modules will be bloom and the stone mapping with the mode Aces. It works very nice with the glowing things, and the rest is up to your liking. Let's create a shader graph. Right click, create shader graph, URP, and lit shader graph. Let's call it fire shader graph and double click to open it. First, let's configure our graph settings. So just check this allow material override. It will allow us to change these settings from our inspector. Then a surface type transparent, blending mode additive, and let's check the alpha clipping. Let's uncheck cast shadows. We do not want our quad to cast any shadows, and same for the receive shadows. And yep, that's pretty much it. Now we need a texture for our fire, so let's quickly create a property of type texture 2D. Let's call it main texture, and in the node settings, let's give a default of our fire. Now I've created this fire texture using GIMP with a simple smooth brush and a smudge tool. I will give a link for this one, but you can create your own. Just notice how I left plenty of space from the edges. That's important. Make sure you do the same. Okay, let's drag that in. Sample it with sample texture 2D node. Let's also create another property for color. So property color, let's call it base color. And the settings, let's set the mode to HDR, select a orangish looking color, and drag that in, and multiply with our sample texture. Just like that. And hook it into our emission, because fire basically emits the color. Now let me just adjust the preview to the quad so it looks, we can see the preview here. Let's set a base color black. Now let's take our sample texture and hook it into the alpha. Now this alpha clip threshold, what it does is it has a value of 0.5, so it is telling Unity that if a pixel is 50% or less opaque, simply do not render it. Notice what happens if I change this value in the preview, right? I want to access this one from the inspector, so let's create a property, this time a float, call it clip threshold and give a default value of 0.02, and select mode to slider with 0 to 1 because this is the valid range for the alpha clip threshold. Let's drag that in and assign it to the alpha clip threshold. Okay, so we want to distort this UV or this texture procedurally. So to do that, let's add a simple noise, and I want to change the scale from the inspector. So let's create another property, float. Let's call it distortion scale. Give a default of something like 10. Drag it and assign it to the scale. Now we want to scroll this noise. And to do that, we need tiling and offset node. So let's create tiling and offset node and feed its output to UV. Now to scroll this vertically, we need to change the Y value of the offset, just like that. We want to change it over time, so let's add a time node. Time node. Let's grab the output of the time and multiply it with a float to control the speed. And to control the speed from the inspector, you guessed it, let's create another property, float, call it speed. And let's give a default of 0.5. Let's drag that in, multiply with our time, and now the offset expects vector 2, but we have a float value, so let's create a vector 2 node and feed the multiply output into the Y and grab this vector 2 output and pass it into the offset. So now it's scrolling in the Y axis but in downwards. We can simply set the speed in negative value to fix this, but I want to invert it in the shader itself so that the positive value scrolls upward and the negative value scrolls the downward. To do just that, let's take the output of our speed and multiply it with -1 and then feed this output of the multiply into this multiply node, and now it's scrolling upward. Very easy. Okay, so our goal is to distort this texture's UV with this scrolling noise. And to do that, let's create another tiling and offset node. Just like that. Now we need to mix this, but we can't really just add this UV to the noise. See what happens if we do that. Let me just add and grab this output into UV. See what happens. Why? Because it's adding to both our tiling values and offset values, so it's also creating a tiley effects as well. And same is true for multiply node. So to mix these two, we have a handy little node called blend node. Let's create blend node. Let's grab the tiling and offset and feed it into base. Let's grab the noise and feed it into blend. And this opacity determines how much we want to mix this blend input to our base input. It also has different modes, but overlay seems to work best in our case. So let's keep it like that. And let's grab the output and feed it into this UV. Now we have a fiery looking texture, which we can adjust with this opacity value. But I don't like the static value, so I will grab the sine time from here. Sine time. Sine time basically gives value from minus 1 to 1 over time. And let's just feed it into remap node. Remap node will, as the name implies, remap these values, this sine value, which has the original value range of minus 1 to 1, and remap them to something like 0.4 and 0.8. What am I doing? 0.8. Type in a value that works great for you. And feed its output into this opacity. So now we have our fire that behaves a bit more naturally. Let me just clear things up a bit. Let's save our shader and let's create a material. Right click, create material, and call it fire. And into our scene view, let's assign this to our fire quad and type in the values that works for us. Bit reddish. Speed 0.8. Let's readjust this. And boom, our shader part is done. However, it's still not looking as the intro I showed you earlier. So let's add a cherry on top. So add a point light as a child of our quad. Go light, point light. Then give a color that matches with our base color, so a little orangish. Yep. And add intensity and range that makes sense, so let's just decrease it a bit, 0.3. Range, yeah. And the indirect multiplier is only supported by the real-time directional light. We are using point light. So let's set it to 0 and shadow type to soft shadows. Let's just increase and readjust the point light like that. And we have a nice little shadows. But a shadow this type of fire creates will not be still shadows. So to look it a bit more natural, all we need to do is move this point light over time like this. And to do that, let's create a script. Call it light movement. And double click to open it. Now let's create a variable for our movement speed. So private, because I do not want any other script to access it. So private, then the type will be float, so it can hold the decimal values. And let's name it move speed. And give default of something like 0.5. And then F is to pay respect. And this little F denotes it's indeed a float value. And then I want to access it from the inspector, so let's throw in the serialized field attribute. Now let's create another variable for our movement range, basically how many units we want to move our light. So let's call it move units and give a default of something like 0.3. Now let's create another variable, private, this time vector 3, to hold our position, our original position of the point lights, and call it offset, because I'm going to use this as an offset. And in a wake method, let's grab our local position. So offset equals transform dot local position. Now in the update, I would like to just keep the axis modifiers there. In the update, let's use the sine wave function, which resides in mathf library or mathf class, so mathf dot sine, and it will return value from -1 to 1 based on whatever parameter we feed in. So let's give pass time dot time into our move speed, which determines how quickly we get -1 to 1, basically the frequency of our sine wave, and then multiply this result, multiply it with our move units. Let's save them into the variable of type float and name it move value. Now let's just set the local position of our light based on this move value. So transform dot local position, and it accepts vector 3, so new vector 3, then pass move value into x, half of the move value into y, so divide by 2, and I don't want to change z, so 0. Then add our offset, and that's it. Let's go back to Unity. Assign this to our point light. Let's save and hit play. And we can adjust the speed here, just like that. So let's give a 3 and a move unit of something like 0.1, no, 0.05, 0.1, yeah, it looks great. And now we have a moving shadows, yay! So that's pretty much the video, but we have created a very basic shader. We can also create a bit complex effect by using and mixing multiple noises with different speed and directions. What about different types of noises? What if we add multiple quads with different materials which has different values? But I will leave that to you guys to experiment. If you find the video helpful, consider like, share and subscribe. If you have any questions, post them in the comments, and I will provide a link for a texture and script file that we have just created. That's it from me, and I will see you guys in the next one.